Yo, what's up, guys? It's Mike here from Aerovox Studios, and today I'm going to show you one of my favorite plugins for mixing a fat bass tone. Let's get into it. All right, so in the session, you can see all right here in like this yellowish color. It's all inactive, but these are all my drum tracks. I just have them summed right here to a stereo track. And I'm just gonna have the drum soloed, and then I've got my bass right here, and these four tracks are bass with all the effects. And they're just going to their bass bus. All right, now the trick I'm gonna show you today, it's just one plugin all the way at the very end of my chain. So whatever you're doing to all your bass tracks to get them to sound however they sound, keep doing that, that's cool. But like at the very end of your bass chain, that's where I use this trick, okay? It's a real simple little plugin. It's called the MV2. All right, it's like 30 bucks. Maybe it's like 50 bucks right now, I don't know. But you know, wait till tomorrow or the next day or someday. One day this month, guaranteed, they're gonna have this plugin for $29.99. Are you out of your mind? So yeah. Anyways, this is what it looks like. Let me show you what the track sounds like with MV2 on the bass, and then I'll turn it off and we'll check out the difference here. Okay, without. Still cool, but not quite cutting it. See what that does? Yeah, that takes the effeminate right out of that bass tone, doesn't it? So that is sick. So let's talk about what's going on with this guy right here, okay? I've got a bunch of stuff going on the bass bus. Trim, little bit of filtering, channel strip, some dynamic EQ, some saturation going on mid-side, and then MV2 is at the end of it, all right? And all I'm doing is bringing up these lows right here. It's just the low frequency information that's in the bass tone, and I'm bringing up the highs here. I know it looks like I'm bringing this down, but I assure you, when I pull this down, it's getting louder. And if I wanted to gain match it, I got the output right here, but I didn't mess with that so you could really hear it, like, yeah, what this thing is doing. So let's put this in factory default here and mute the drums, and let me show you what it does when I bring up the lows. It's getting beefy, you know what I'm saying? Big time beef. Like, I just got out of a gnarly burrito curling session, and yo, I'm gonna probably have a big burp from all the BCAAs I just had, you know what I'm saying? Big carne asada, always. And so that's what this is doing, you know? So let's do it with and without the plug-in on. Off. On. Just hear all that low end come through super fat, right? Now let's check out what the highs are gonna do. Amazing. That's amazing. So let me turn it off. Back on. Yeah, that really just brings the aggression in the pick, right? The distortion that I have in the bass tone helps kind of pop that forward. And the bottom end, it's just like making it big and a little scary, you know what I'm saying? Like, I never turned this all the way up, and I'm kind of scared to do it. You should actually do that. Comment down below. Let me know what happens. I hope you don't blow yourself up. You guys make it out of that just fine. But anyways, yo, this is my favorite thing. Like, mix bass however you mix it. But at the end of your chain, slap this MV2 on there and comment down below if that made your bass sound worse, because I would be absolutely shocked. All right, MV2 is doing it. So let's set this back up at a more tasteful, you know what I'm saying, more healthy proper dose here of this MV2. And let's play it with the drums and the guitars in. And you're going to hear when I pull this MV2 out and back in, man, the bass is a whole nother thing with the guitar player going at the same time. Okay. Unmute the guitars down here. Here we go. All right, MV2's in right now. Let's take it out. Just completely disappears in the mix. Now, some of you might be saying, Mike, why don't you gain match it? You should be gain matching it. That's the only reason why. Like, no, bro. I could. Okay, I could. But I kind of want to turn the bass up anyways, honestly. Realistically, that's what I'm thinking in my brain. But we'll turn it down. Let's just do it again one more time. Just to, you know, the naysayers. Let's just shut them the f*** up. Yeah. Okay. So, pretty complicated plugin, I know, guys. It's a tough one to digest. So, you know what I'm saying? You might want to bust out the manual before you dive into this wild thing. I don't know. It's up to you. But, yeah, waves.com. Go pick this guy up and thank me later. Yo, so thanks for stopping by and checking out the video, guys. I greatly appreciate it. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share with the homies, hook them up with this tip right here. Don't forget to check out the description down below because I'm hooking you guys up with a free template that I use every single day. I love you guys, and I will catch you at the next one.
Peace.